edition of the NFL on EA Sports. Today, after a topsy-turvy opening weekend, it's on to week two, and we've got a good one here. As it'll be the Washington Commanders taking on the Denver Broncos. The final weekend of the summer. Hope you're enjoying it wherever you are as we are off and running on EA Sports. From deep in the end zone, he's going to bring this out. And he'll be dropped at the 21-yard line. So bringing it out of the end zone proves not a good decision. Loses him about 4 yards.
At their own 21-yard line.
Get the upper hand as they're on the board first here this afternoon. Extra point by Sloan is up and good. And that makes the score 7-0.
Commanders 7, Broncos 0.
Joey Sly now to kick off after the touchdown.
The Broncos take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
And the Broncos now with a first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. The leading rusher in NCAA history for the last time still, Jerry McLaughlin. No gain on the play there, second down.
No gain on the play. Brings up second and 10 at the 25-yard line.
From the shotgun, Wilson. And he misses it.
Look
at this
score we just saw, now 14-7, so a chance to march down the field here, try to tie this football.
Now. Throwing is Wilson. Gibson decides he needs to bring it out. Out there, set ready for this next drive, the Washington offense.
And now last drive, so successful with the ground game, ending in a touchdown. Do you stick with that formula?
That would be the number one thing you would think of. But you know, there was a big time coach in the state of Ohio once said, if you throw the ball, if you put it in the air, three things can happen, and two of them are bad. He would have kissed it on the ground.
Second and six, just inside the 30. Robinson with another carry. And he gets this one just shy of the 40, down at the 39. 10 yards there, good for Washington first down.
Don't get much better than his last year. Shot during an attempted robbery just 13 days before the regular season. He made it back by week 5 and played in 12 games for Washington. Even better, gained almost 800 yards leading the Commanders.
On first down, now.
Into a big play. That's why Washington took him 16th overall in 2022, and that's what he showed in a strong rookie season. Expect a big jump for him in year two.
So a first and 10 now in Denver territory at the 43. Powell out of the shotgun.
Escape this drive.
halftime, we'll ship you off to Orlando. Jonathan Coachman will have first half highlights and analysis from a back and forth first half that we've seen. On third down, Wilson. At the line, ready to go. Now remember, they were just out here a moment ago through the pick six, so we'll see if they can take better care of the football this way. Yeah,
sometimes, partner, it gets almost bad that you just throw the pick six and you come right back out on the field. You're not over on the sidelines. You're not hearing them. Hey, you'll get them next time. Hey, don't worry about it. All that stuff just goes right out the window. You're right back out on the field with a chance to attack. Defensive backs and speed, unable to find an open hole to complete that pass.
Riley Dixon
down to all is the punter, Riley Dixon. Only two punts for him last week in the loss as he gets this one away. A 40-yard punt, 1 yard on the return. And the Commanders will take over the first and 10
at their own 23-yard line.
The Washington offense at the line and ready to roll. Still more than a minute to go, so there is time if they want to mount something here.
Not only time, but they have three timeouts to get this ball as well. So that changes everything that you're doing here.
Sends this one away. Taken right around the 44. It's a return of 52 yards. And he gets over the first down, switching hands with very little time remaining until the half. Onto the field, ready to start their next drive. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively offensively
Jersey.
We saw a pretty entertaining first half, close ball game. Remember there toward the end of the second quarter, the opposition scored to take the lead. Now we'll see if these guys can get a score here. Now, as he'll punt it away for the second time. Fighting him off. A good return there, 17 yards. And it will be Washington football now, first and 10.
At their own 41-yard line.
Out there, set ready for this next drive, the Washington offense. And both of these defenses have been stifling these last few drives offensively. Just not able to get anything going, so what needs to change?
I think a lot of the guys will go back and review, so to speak, because everyone has someone assigned to how did each player work. Okay, what do we use that kind of works for us during this game? Try and get back some of those plays, as well as the possibility of showing something you haven't shown already in this game and trying to change things up.
We'll see if they take the advice of Mr. Davis. Just to the 47.
That's what happens sometimes when you abandon the running game. It's hard to get back to it because once guys get out of that mentality of firing out and hitting people, hard to get them started again occasionally.
Now trying to pick it up on third. He's going to get that to his running back. And he goes down, but not before getting his inside the 25. It was third and short, and they go flying past the line for a gain of nearly 30 yards. Looking for the lead, trying to get to 2-0. Here's first and 10. And that will give, but this is going to be a reverse. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and 5.
Red Hopkins concerned.
They have to feel pretty good about getting that type of a gain, considering the blitz that they just had against them.
Second and 5. And now we'll throw it. It's caught Robinson. Back at the 23-yard line. A loss of 4 yards on the play. And that's going to set up a tough 3rd and 9. Let's face it, a lot of time on extra points, the effort is not what it is when you're trying to
run the field.
No, no doubt about it. Before, when the ball was snapped to the 2-yard line, it's really a virtual chip shot. Now, everyone believes they can get to it and knock it away. And we know how crucial every point is. So, the defensive guys, there's been a lot more time trying to get that done, which means there's more pressure on the offensive guys trying to kick it.
Well, on first down, Wilson.
That's good for a Denver home.
place yourself really on the line of scrimmage. Put your heels on the goal line at worst. And if they're going to throw the ball, make them throw it over your head because they're going to run out of space because they're off of the end zone. Never really got to touch on the first down
at their own 34-yard line.
The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. Well, that last touchdown we just saw, what an important one. Now it's back to a two-score deficit for this crew as they take the field here. They are in desperate need of finding the end zone. And getting this just shy of midfield, they'll spot it at the 49. That play going for 16 yards to start the drive. First down.
First and 10 at the 49-yard line.
Now it's Wilson. That's taken in by Gorsuch.
And get a score because they know they've got to get that done and get the ball.
From deep in the end zone, and the decision to bring it out, not a good one, as he's tackled at the 15.
Washington takes over first and 10 at their own 15-yard line.
They're set ready for this next drive, the Washington offense. This game has really flipped on its head. Two unanswered touchdowns. Instead of second and goal now in a one-score game. Here now, second and goal. Williams. So their move is to decline that so they don't get another second down. It'll be third.
So that has to tell us that they're pretty confident in their third down defense, right?
Absolutely.
Whether it's a sub package or nickel package, whatever they want to run out there, they feel like they can defend here on third down.
What do they have for this? Third and 11.